Okay, interrupts can be classified in one other way. There is another way to classify interrupts. Okay, either interrupt is going to be maskable or non-maskable. Okay, what is the difference here is, maskable interrupts can be delayed. We can delay maskable interrupts. These can be delayed. We can do masking, okay? For some reason, if you are executing some important program and you do not want any interruption, you can just mask these interrupts. Fine, they can be masked, can be delayed. Even if an interrupt is raised, will not be bothered. Okay, but this non-maskable interrupt, they cannot be delayed. They have to be serviced. Have to be serviced in any case. So, of all the interrupts that we have learned, trap is a non-maskable interrupt. Trap is a non-maskable interrupt. Okay, already also I told you that trap is given in cases when there is a huge problem, like the power supply, there's a problem with power supply or something, some big problem, only then we are giving trap. So trap is a non-maskable interrupt. That is, if the trap pin is made high, it has to be served. ISR of trap has to be executed. This cannot be masked. Other instructions which are RST 7.5, RST 6.5. Okay, all these can be masked using some instructions. So SIM, set interrupt mask, and DI, disable interrupt. These are the two instructions using which you can mask these three interrupts, and INTR can be masked using DI. So we're going to see how using these instructions we can mask the interrupts, what happens after masking, what all can be masked, what cannot be. But for now, we have learned two classification of the interrupts. One is vectored and non-vectored. Vector interrupts are those which have fixed address. They're going to go to fixed memory location. Internally, a call function is going to be executed, which is going to take the microprocessor to a fixed memory location, fixed address, and ISR is going to be executed. Okay, RST 7.5, 6.5, 5.5 and TRAP are vectored interrupts. That is, their memory location, their address is known, whereas INTR is a non-vectored interrupt. After that, we have learned that interrupts can be maskable or non-maskable. Maskable interrupts are those which can be delayed by using some instructions, some program. RST 7.5, 6.5, 5.5 and INTR are maskable interrupts, and TRAP is a non-maskable interrupt. That is, it has to be serviced. Whenever this pin is raised, it cannot be delayed. Okay. Now we are going to look at a flip-flop implementation of the interrupts. How these interrupts are being employed? Like, what does their circuit look like? Okay. So now we look at the several interrupts. We've already seen that there are five hardware interrupts in 8085: RST 7.5, RST 6.5, RST 5.5, TRAP, and INTR. Also, we've discussed that there are two types of interrupts, maskable interrupts and non-maskable, of which TRAP was a non-maskable interrupt. That is, it cannot be delayed. Whenever TRAP comes, we have to service it. And other four interrupts, that is RST 7.5, 6.5, 5.5 and INTR are maskable interrupts. That is, using instructions like SIM, set interrupt mask, and DI, disable interrupt, we can mask these interrupts. We can mask these four interrupts. So, see what happens is, there we are using AND gate, D flip-flop, SR flip-flop, these M7.5, 6.5, these are a group of D flip-flops for the functioning of interrupts, okay? Whenever we want to stop an interrupt from coming, whenever we want to service an interrupt, we want to prioritize one interrupt, we want to make an interrupt which triggered, level triggered, we are using this circuit to do all that. So, okay, we are going to look one by one for all the interrupts. First, we are taking RST 7.5. So, here we are using a D flip-flop, okay? You might be knowing the working of a D flip-flop, how it works. Whenever you are giving a clock, this is a positive edge triggered clock we are giving to D flip-flop. So, when you are giving a clock to D flip-flop, the output of D flip-flop changes according to the input D, okay? This D stands for data. So, whenever D is 0, Q will be 0 when it gets a clock, and whenever D is 1, Q will be 1. Okay, so D has been made 1 permanently. So whenever this pin is high, this RST 7.5 is going to be high, this D flip flop is going to get a clock and Q is going to get 1. When Q gets 1 means this interrupt has come. And we know the working of an AND gate. An AND gate gives output 1 only when all its inputs are 1. Only when all the inputs are going to be 1, this output is going to be 1. That means for RST 7.5 to appear here at the microprocessor, all the inputs of this AND gate must be 1. Okay, so one input comes from this D flip flop. This D flip flop gives output 1 when this clock, this RST 7.5 is applied as clock to this flip flop. So whenever this is 1, this D will appear here and it will give 1. This M7.5 is mask 7.5. This is to mask an interrupt. Okay, masking is used whenever we want to disable a single interrupt but want to keep enabled all the other outputs. See, there is a interrupt enable flip flop. This is IE flip flop interrupt. Interrupt enable flip flop. So suppose I want to enable the interrupts. I want that any interrupt can come. So I'll give EI as 1. EI is the S input of this SR flip flop, and we know that when S is 1, Q is going to be 1. So all the inputs of the AND gate is going to be 1. Okay, 1 means that any interrupt can come. But suppose I want that any interrupt can come, but this RST 7.5 should not come. So for only masking one of the interrupts, I want all the other interrupts to be enabled, but only one interrupt to be masked. Then I can use this series of D flip-flop, this M7.5, M6.5, M5.5. This is a series of D flip-flops which is used to mask a particular single interrupt. Other interrupts are unchanged. Okay. So what happens here is, see, if EI is 1, that is enable interrupt, then all the input of the AND gates are 1, any interrupt can come. But if I make R as 1, to make R1 there are 3 options. One is DI, DI is disable interrupt. Either you select this option, disable interrupt. If you are disabling the interrupt, R is 1. See, this is a OR gate. OR gate, functioning of OR gate is, if any of the input is 1, the OR gate will give output as 1. So if any of these options is 1, this flip-flop will be reset. Reset means 0 will appear here. If 0 appears here, the 0 will appear at input of every AND gate, and every AND gate will give output 0. That is, no interrupt can reach the microprocessor. So if you disable interrupt, there are instructions to do this. Okay, this is programming. We'll see that after this. So if disable interrupt is done, reset in, okay, this resets the microprocessor. Okay, this is reset in bar. If this is active low signal, so if you are giving this as 0, see, there is a bubble here, this complements this input. It will appear as 1 here, reset in bar. Then also this interrupt enable flip flop is reset and gives output 0. Then there is one option, that is service any interrupt. Whenever the microprocessor is going to branch into any ISR, whenever it has received an interrupt and it is branching into the ISR of that interrupt, it will make service any interrupt as 1. Service any interrupt as 1. So that while an interrupt is serviced, next interrupt cannot come. Okay, next interrupt cannot come. After next, the ISR, okay, we've already discussed it, I think. After end of every ISR, it is the duty of the programmer to put the EI instruction, due to which after end of every ISR, in this flip-flop can be enabled, this flip-flop can be set, so that any other interrupt can come again. If we do not put EI at the end of ISR, no interrupt is going to come, because before branching into the ISR, the microprocessor is making this input as 1, service any interrupt as 1. Okay, fine. So this is the working of this IE flip-flop. It is connected as input to all the interrupts, okay, as input to AND gate of all the interrupts. See, trap is a non-maskable interrupt. Non-maskable interrupt means nobody can stop trap to come. That is why there is no logic gate. Okay, trap is a direct input to the microprocessor. Whenever trap is made high, trap is made 1, it comes directly to the microprocessor. Okay, nobody in the way to stop it. All the other interrupts can be masked. Fine. See, this INTR can be masked only using IE flip-flop, only using the DI, only using DI. Okay, all the other interrupts can be masked using SIM or DI. Fine. So similarly, M5.5, 6.5, 7.5, all these are series of D flip-flops which are used to mask any single interrupt. Fine. And one more thing, see, this RST 7.5, this flip-flop is having an extra input of clear. Okay, this is the active low input. That is, whenever you're getting a zero here in clear, this will clear the flip-flop. Clear the flip-flop means output will be zero. Okay, clearing the flip-flop means output will be zero, the flip-flop will be reset. Now this clear can be zero if either you have done a reset 7.5 flip-flop or service 7.5. Whenever microprocessor is going to service this RST 7.5, it is going to make service 7.5 as 1. Service 7.5 as 1. Okay, why? See, what happens here is, even if this RST 7.5 is 1 for a very small duration, this Q gets 1. Okay, even if this is a pulse like this, this will be stored. Okay, every time this is going to appear, RST 7.5 is going to be appeared. This is the reason, this is another reason why we say that RST 7.5 is level triggered, as well as we say that RST 7.5 is edge triggered. Only even if the edge comes, RST 7.5 is going to be detected. Whereas RST 6.5 and RST 5.5 will have to wait. They have to wait for microprocessor to notice them. Okay, so we say that they are level triggered signals. Why? Because they'll have to wait for the microprocessor to notice them. Fine. They'll have to wait for the microprocessor to notice them. This is not the case with RST 7.5. It is a edge triggered signal. Edge triggered, okay. Even if an edge comes, the microprocessor notices. And trap. Trap is both level triggered and edge triggered. Trap is level triggered as well as edge triggered, okay. It will stay until this microprocessor is going to notice it. Okay, this is a non-maskable interrupt, it will not wait. This will get stored even if it is for a very short duration, very short pulse. This will get stored. The microprocessor can notice it whenever it gets time. Okay, they'll have to wait. These two interrupts are going to wait for the microprocessor to notice them. Okay, so this is how interrupts are going to work. This is all about hardware interrupts. There's one more thing. There are 2-3 instructions, SIM, DI, EI, through which you can mask these interrupts, or you can read the status of pending interrupts. Okay, so we're going to look at the instructions now.